Hello, fellow Rosarians. Thank you for joining me today. So I wanted to share with you day one from the tour. We had our coach take us to the Rose Garden at Mottisfont. Now, some people who aren't garden enthusiasts might say, a garden is a garden is a garden. But as I'm showing you these videos, you're going to see that there's a different feeling as you enter a new garden. As I went into Mottisfont, it was like being at a Black Friday sale. There was a line out the door when it opened for people to get in. There was so much excitement about the Rose Garden. So we got there and were quickly ushered to the front of the line where we went to the Rose Garden. And there's two rooms that you're going to see, a main area front that focuses on the old garden roses, which are going to be pinks and reds and whites with a lot of the blues and the silvers woven in. Because it's an old garden, you're not going to see the yellows and the oranges. Those are more modern roses. Now, once we finish looking through that area and we head into the next room, that's where the modern roses are. And I'm hoping to see a few David Austins. So this rose garden was influenced by Graham Thomas. He was there for several years and put together at his vision. And so the interesting story there that Paul shared with us is we have the Graham Thomas Rose by David Austin, and it's believed that Graham Thomas didn't like yellow. That was one of his least favorite colors. So it's fascinating that we have Graham Thomas and it's yellow. So let's go ahead and show you that garden. Lambert. Province. Koenigen, Denmark. Mundi.
Ferdinand, Zephyrine, Lush Rambler, Sombrio,
yes, I think they have a clean hat. Sun's gone behind the cage.
Louis Side Young, Saleh, Sponge, S-P-O-N-G, Common Moss, so pretty. Isn't that beautiful?
That's a good old Bilchin blow again.
Yeah.
I just love that. Let's see if I can...
Okay, they've got iris in here. Boxwood hedge. And this is called Agatha, here, climbing against this tree. Oh, how wonderful to be in a garden like this every day. Madam Hardy here. Souvenir de Saint Anne's. Apothecary Rose again. Salsinia.
Well, that was joined to the main line one day. You go down to the first castle. Yeah. Right, I better go find him, isn't he? We do our own thing. He likes his photography.
Yeah.
Lovely. It's got to be fun. Oh, God. Are you ready to move on?
You are. Hey, when you are. Be a bit longer if you want.
No, you are actually going to go on. You're just going to tell me.
Fontainebleau. Duchess de Buccleuch. Violette. Hippolyte.
Germans. Did you miss that? I haven't been shot since I...
Comte de Chabord is all around the front here. Magna Charta. Spencer. Smith's Parish. Duke of Edinburgh. Duchess de Berry. This is Dean Hill. Oh, Dean Hill is on the wall. Blush to Mask. Breeze Hill is on the wall. It's a beautiful cream color with hints of pale yellow. It's very fragrant. This little pretty Felicia. I wish I knew the name of this one. I'm really drawn to the darker purple color against the light purple. I think that would look beautiful with my lavender. Ooh, here's the name. It's a centifolia. How fun these moss buds are. This is called Look at that. I love it. Duchess de Montebello. Lita. Louis Odier.
She's my step.
Oh.
Yes. Yeah, Mike's dad's second one. She's lovely.
Robert Diablo.
This is striking.
exactly what he did on our day trip. And he's been back a couple of times and he's good to work.
Rose de Rochette. Lady Mary Fitz.
What's the title?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, that's the way.
Lady Mary Fitzwilliam. Oh, I didn't see this one. I must have missed it just now.
Jacques.
So do you still remember your Qigong, man?
A little bit, but I don't think I've This garden is so beautiful, and I'm just at a loss, really, for words. And this is the first garden that we've gone to, and Paul's telling me that they're all going to be this magnificent. It is, it's just, you know, the word that I'm using is overwhelming, because there's so much color and things to take in and pictures to take and roses that you've never seen before. This is called West Green.
Yes.
And getting ideas for how you want to build your garden to mimic some of these concepts, mass plantings, borders, places to draw the eye. On the wall is a rose called the Garland. It's huge. One of the things that I'm taking away from this garden is also at the entrances, they have placed very fragrant roses. So if there is a rose that brings you particular joy, a fragrance, you're going to want to consider putting that near an entrance. So pretty.
I know.
I hope some of these photos are going to do it justice.
Thank you.
got lamb's ears and alliums, a lavender edge. So they've created a structure here on their own to support the rose. That is Nastarama. Nice blocks of perennials. Lavender hedge, which is beautiful, and I can't grow where I live. Looks like they have at least three of each variety planted. Madame Lando. There's a rambler. Look at the beautiful arches. Here we've got clematis in with the rose. Laura DeVost. Excuse me. Isaac Pear. Estelle de Orleans.
But I think they've had to. Look, I think all these have been boxed like that.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know, chop them off. Right, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Charles de Mills. Ghislaine. I didn't realize that the blooms are so small on Ghislaine. But she is growing up a tree and very happy. I might have to think about that. So here they have roses against all of the brick walls supported with wire, and they have, in this garden, old roses only. And I asked Paul, why aren't we seeing yellows and oranges? And he said that the old roses are primarily going to be varieties of white, red, and pink. Etna. Little white pet. Now I saw this color from across the garden. This is called Archiduke Joseph. Let's look at that name. Look at the coloring on this. Really pretty. And an aged bloom. Let me see if it has a scent. It does. It's very light. This is Crepuscule. Laurie DeVost. Mm-hmm. This is Enfant de France. And that clematis on the back wall is so beautiful.
There it is.
Alfred Colomb. So I hope you enjoyed seeing that garden. It was, I think, overwhelming for me and maybe some of the other people in the group. We had ample time to be able to walk through and take it all in, but it was a huge garden. Stay tuned for the next video when we talk about Lady Clark's garden.